GTM podcast Buddha Stories, the collection story of Lord Buddha's past life where you can enjoy and learn the Buddhist wisdom along with it. So let's get into our story, shall we? From the last episode, two men travel afar from their kingdoms. One man who had a beautiful face like a moon and looked a little older. His name was Sutasoma. He was the son of King Korapaya, the king of Indapati in the region of Kuru. Another man who was good looking with a refined skin. His name was Brahmadatta. He was the son of the king Kasikaraja, the king of Kasi region. They met at abandoned hut along the way. After having dinner, they got to know and become friends. Brahmadatta noticed that Sutasoma looked older and more mature, so he respects Sutasoma as his older brother. That night, both men slept well because they were both tired from traveling for many days. The next morning, they shared a breakfast and then traveled together to study at Master Tisapamoka school in Taxila. When they reached Taxila, they announced themselves and requested admission to enter the school. At the same time, they gave tuition fee to the master. After being admitted to the school, it turned out that Prince Sutasoma was the eldest among all the princes and students. He was also very smart, diligent, and the most determined person there. After being admitted to the school, it turned out that Prince Sutasoma was the eldest among all the students. He was very smart, diligent, and very capable, so he was able to study all the subjects quickly and accurately, then graduate before anyone else within a few years. Since he completed his studies ahead of the schedule, the master requested that he stay and help advise other students in his class who did not complete their study yet. Prince Sutasoma accepted the offer. This was due to he wanted to wait for his friend, Prince Brahmadatta, to complete his study so that they could travel back to their kingdoms at the same time. Therefore, Prince Sutasoma was not only a close friend in the eyes of Prince Brahmadatta, but was also a teacher who helped him in his studies. Prince Brahmadatta even respected Prince Sutasoma as if he were another one of his teachers. In the end, all the students in the same class complete their study at the same time. After receiving confirmation from their master, they had completed all their requirements and then received permission to return to their kingdoms. They all said goodbye to their master according to the custom and traveled home together. When they passed the entrance to Taxila, which was where everyone has to separate, Prince Sutasoma, who was the eldest and had the status of teacher among all the students, gave the following advice. We left our kingdoms to study. At this time, we have learned every subject as we intended to. Our parents were anxious, waiting with hope to see our success. They will be happy to see us return with success. For those of you who are sons of kings or governors, may you behave so that your parents can trust you, and may you display the skill you have learned so that everyone can accept that you are capable of ruling your kingdom. For those of you who are given the throne, may you follow my advice. Many ask, what do you want us to do, Sutasoma? I would like you to observe the 8 precepts every mid-month. Do not miss a single month, or do not make others suffer, no matter what situation is. This is all I ask. Can you accept my advice? They all reply, yes, certainly, Sutasoma. The next eldest student said, reassuring, do not worry, Sutasoma. We study those subjects with the purpose to rule the kingdoms. And the principle clearly states that ruler must not exploit or take advantage or persecute others under their command. We need to sympathize with them and provide them with the great benefits we still remember well. It is good that you still remember, Sutasoma said. I just want to remind you again, I wish everyone luck in the future. If anything happens, let us keep in touch. Then they waved goodbye to each other and went to their separate ways. When they reached their kingdoms, many of them were given the throne, a prize from their fathers, and become king. Others become governor of their towns. Each of them sent a message to Prince Sudarsoma, who has also given the throne from his father, King Korapaya, to be the king of Indapati. Prince Brahmadatta was also given the throne to be the king of Benares and sent a message as well. When King Sudarsoma received the message from his student, he sent a message back, remind them not to be negligent in their rule and to remember the promise they made before they separate. Back to Prince Brahmadatta. After he was given the throne, he ruled over his kingdom in peace. When he became elder, he was married and had many princes and princesses. Also, he always observed the 8 precepts every mid-month, but he could not skip any single day without meat. All his meals need to include meat, otherwise he could not eat. The chef knew this very well. Even in the Buddhist holy days, no one sold meat because they refrained from killing animals. For your information, many people practice this on the Buddhist holy day, abstention from killing animals on every new moon and full moon. The chef was still able to use meat as set aside from the previous day to prepare meals. So the chef was always trusted by the king. On one Buddhist holy day, it just happened that the meat that was set aside was stolen by the dog within the royal palace due to the chef's negligence. Hence, he had to quickly go out and buy the meat on the market. However, since it was on a Buddhist holy day, people did not kill animals, so no one sold meat. The chef became so frightened, he had a cold sweat all over his body. He ran to every market where he thought might sell meat, but was disappointed. So he just sat hopelessly, thinking that he would most certainly be punished or get fired from his job. What would happen to the chef? Will he be able to find the meat? Let's find out what's gonna happen in the next episode, GTM Podcast.